Okay, so we have arrived at the final. The only thing I'm going to do now is get some different camera angles. So I'm going to use the camera and I'm going to zoom in and maybe get some details that'll make the animation a little more interesting. So I might go down and focus on this little guy on the floor. Oops. And then I might get the little guy in green. So I'm going to go and catch these frames. So this is almost like making a movie. You're making a film. You want to get little pieces, little shots of each part of the scene. You want to make it interesting. You can make each frame as interesting as you can get it. So I'm going to switch up here the orientation of the camera. Notice that the camera is pointing this way, but the gizmo is pointing this way. So I'm going to switch this to local. So now the gizmo is local with the camera, so it'll be easier for me to go in and out. So for example, this little guy, I might start here. Maybe I'll move it over a smidge. So I might start here with frame one. And then I might move up, let's say camera 100. I might then move this up. And I don't have to add the frames in because remember I have this little dot. I have this. So anytime I move the camera, if I move over a little bit more and move the camera, it's going to add a keyframe. So I'm going to undo that last one. So this one might just be the camera moving up like this. But when you're doing this, don't forget that you have to, I'm going to put this to one, I think. Make sure that that's on one. One thing that you have to remember is the focus ring. So just remember the focus ring. You want to make sure that you're focused on whatever the subject is that you want in focus. So I'm going to move the focus ring over. I'll scale it down to make it a little easier. And I'll move it back so it's like right where his head is so that that's in focus. And if I want everything else to be less focused, then I need to go to the camera, go to the camera options, and then the f-stop, I'm going to put that down. Put it down to like 2. Maybe even lower. Put it down to like 0.5. And that's a very different frame. You can zoom in and kind of see what's in frame. It looks like I do want his. Okay, so let's make it a little interesting. Let's start at the feet. Or maybe we'll start at the head. So we can start here and then we can move it. And we can actually move the focus ring in a bit. And maybe at his face. So the focus ring is actually going to move. The focus ring is animated too. So now the head will be in focus. And actually, I kind of like how zoomed in the camera was. So, I'll go back to the camera. And I can set the focal length. So I can zoom this in. I think that looks great. And I'll move it over a smidge. And then let's see how that looks. Okay, we're a little out of frame. We move a little out of frame. So I'm just going to edit this until it's the frame that I want. Maybe I'll even rotate it a little bit. I'm going to go to the front and I'm going to set the focal length by tapping here. And then I'm going to go to the last frame right here, or not the last frame, but the last keyframe. I'm going to move it a little bit over the, I'm going to rotate it a little bit this way. And I'm going to go in a bit. Right around there. And I'm going to set that focus length. So that should kind of zoom in a bit. Okay, so that actually looks kind of cool. Okay, so I do like it, but I'm going to go ahead and delete this last one because I want the move to be less. So what else I'll do is I'll put this where I want it to start. And we can take a look at the items as well. Just that might be more clear. We can see all the items. Okay, that's good. And then I'll go to 140. I'll move it up. And I'm going to rotate this. Okay, let's take a look at the focus ring. That looks nice, but I think I want it a little more down on him. Okay, that might be a little much, but we'll see. I like that. I want to make sure that it's easing to a stop, so I'm going to go back to the graph editor and just make sure that it's bezier. Yeah, I think that's nice. Okay, I think that's nice. The only thing I want to play around with is what if I want to rotate it a little bit. Beautiful. So I think I'm going to end this at 160. And that's essentially how I'll have that part of the animation. So I'm just going to do a few different little camera scenes like this, make it look very cinematic, and then you have your little keyframe animation with these little robots. But I love it. I had so much fun. For anyone that stayed, and just I hope that you were able to absorb some things, to soak it up. I'm going to make a lot more videos about stuff like this. Little bite-sized portions. I know this was a lot, but I was just trying to flow and just kind of show you how I work. And maybe this can help if you run into some of the issues I run into. That's all Blender is troubleshooting, is running into problems, and then having to figure out how to fix them. Like literally, that's what 90% of Blender is. But I enjoyed it, and I really appreciate your time in this study hall session. Thank you. If I could tell my younger self one thing, it'd be not to follow all the rules when it comes to art and creativity.
Blah, 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 yakety smackety.
It's so easy to get caught up in how things should be or have been. That kind of thinking, obsolete. My name is Dave Reed. I'm a 3D artist and content creator living in Brooklyn, New York, and I've been a 2D traditional artist all of my life, and recently discovered a love for 3D sculpting and 3D animation. You might have come across some of my pretty incredible children's books, including The Dream Machine, or my social media collabs with the American Museum of Natural History. You might recognize my creative visual time lapses on both YouTube and Instagram. 3D sculpting inspires me because it allows me to bring my art to life in a whole new way. Learning the technical aspects of Nomad and Blender is kind of a natural progression and allows me to bring my creativity to the next level. Today, we're learning a complete workflow from Nomad Sculpt to Blender. We're learning to take our sculpts to the next level and beyond. We're gonna bridge this gap from the ground up. And today's project is gonna be a robot. Who doesn't love robots? Especially cute ones, just saying. We'll make a quick model in Nomad, which we will then export over into Blender. It'll be a complete pipeline to Blender, which will give you greater control over your sculpt and your render. You can easily follow along at home with your iPad or Android tablet for Nomad Sculpt. You'll need Blender with a Mac or PC computer. I'm excited to teach this class because we're on the frontier of using Nomad Sculpt as a starting point for Blender. The 3D landscape has changed so dramatically. I love pushing the envelope, that constant forward motion of artistic technology. By the end of this class, I hope you walk away with some new tools, new inspiration, and new ideas. All right, let's get started.